Hello and welcome again to Stocks Advisor channel. Here at our channel, we are looking for interesting buy opportunities for US-based stocks. In today's episode, we will talk about CrowdStrike Holdings Incorporated, traded at NASDAQ, ticker name CRVD. Well, CrowdStrike is now in a major correction phase, and you can see it from moving averages behavior and actually the straight decline channels that are observed already almost a month. So the one is here, let's call it channel R1, and then we have upper channel, which is actually an opening channel, and this is a channel R2. So this is a diverging opening channel of descending, and from today's candle we see that the price didn't hold. It was repassed from moving average 20, this green line. So what is expected further is further decline all the way towards R1, where we will might be buying the first opportunity. And to understand this, how to trade here further, let's do a quick analysis for CRWD. As always, we have our three moving averages depicted here on the left. You see their legends. These are moving averages 20, 50, and 200, being green, blue, and red line correspondingly. If you look at them here, you can see that moving average 20 is already a long time actually bounded and flat, and now it's kind of descending. Recently, we saw magic cross down here when it crossed from the top moving average 50. And although it didn't cause a massive decline of the price, but it kind of a little bit delayed. So we will have it now, because what we see from today's candle, it's a red candle with bigger upwards and smaller downward shadow. And the upward shadow is exactly touching R2 and actually moving average 20. So moving average 20 this time worked as a very strong resist, which is also a major sign for strong corrective moves. And now, after having already actually second wave of the correction are finished. So this is the one, this is second. Now we are on the third wave, and the major rebounds will take place. Most probably we will go to the trading channel of between 160-140, which is a very strong actually support level here. If you look, that was formed during the, let's say, upwards move in December. So this will form for us the first buying opportunity here, and it will be right there. So a little bit higher than 140 actually overall, but this is kind of a broad, big, very nice channel to enter. Still, you might say there is a middle of it as well, which will work as a volatility point. So you can also see this line just exactly at 122, where the moving average 200 is at the moment, and the green line. So with this, actually you can see that the volatility level V1 and these two support levels, the green levels, S1 and S2, are forming a very interesting entry opportunity. And here advice would be wait a little bit for that coming, because overall you can see that still the let's say the bottom of the opening descending channel R1 R2, so the bottom of R1 is a very strong attractor here, and the price is expected to go all the way down until there, and there we can start entering. So anything immediately at S1 and below, all the way to V1, even S2, would be a buy here. So let's write it immediate buy at these channels, at these levels. And if we would write it here in the center, this would be something between 142 all the way to actually 161 here. Yes, a little bit broad channel actually, but also you see that the price change, the price action is also quite big, so we can use the broad channels to enter here as well. And this channel will form actually a triple support, will be very strong, because it will be moving average 200 here, the red line coming, making it as an extra support. Then it will be the standing line R1 working as a support level, and also actually S1, S2 channel also working as support level. So it's a triple support, very rare case, especially for corrective moves when you have it. But yes, in this case, that's going like that. If you look at other parameters here, you see RSI slightly declining further, but then is ready for rebounds. So this small decline is still expected, and therefore we could go all the way to S1, S2. MACD here is increasing, so after secondary wave it's improving, but it is improving with the second derivative being negative, so it's actually kind of convex like this, and this means, so it's going like this instead of normal recovery like that, and this means that still it might show, let's say, some extra declines and only then to recover. Therefore, expecting S1, S2 channel is, let's say, very reasonable here. We still might pierce it a little bit even on a corrective move, but not that expected overall, but still possible. And if this is going to happen, of course, then the next support level would be very strong here, which will be in between 130 and 118 almost, you can say. And with this being said, this will form for us a support channel S3, S4, where we could enter again for, let's say, technical averaging down. And in general, it's so strong, S1, S2, that's not even expected probably that we go lower. But still, if we pierce towards S3, S4, it would be immediate buy again to average down. And still, why is it possible? Because the volume traded today, you see, is quite high, a bit higher than the average. So it might be some shorting actions taking place, also causing the price to decline. And then we need to take into account also the negative catalyst possibility, or let's say not to take into account, but mitigate that risk. We'll talk about it later. First, let's write the second channel here to our table. This would be 118 towards 140. 130. And then what we need to do if a negative catalyst comes. If negative catalyst comes at the moment when it's not expected, of course, this could cause the price really to decline, really drop. And when you do the technical analysis, or actually, to be more precise, a mixed analysis that we do at our channel, meaning that we do technical analysis, secondary, we do non-linear averaging down strategy discussion that we do now based on support resist levels. And the third one is to mitigate risks due to negative catalysts or some reorganization in the company or whatever related to stocks and market. To take this into account, you need to actually prepare for support at the very basic level from where the price just technically or physically cannot decline, because it's a very principal levels historically formed from where actually anyone would buy. And this is the level here, this trading channel that was formed by June, actually from July to August, even earlier. And this will make for us S5, S6 levels. Therefore, again, not expected we go there, but just to have it as a very major mitigating level, this would be here, which is again between, if you would write it in numbers, would be between 96 to actually 106. The reason we discussed that low, because again, it's not expected to go, but it's always better to have some funds when others will be, if the price goes there, when others will be stopping losses, taking losses, you will be just patiently averaging down and preparing for rebounds. And whenever rebounds takes place, of course, if it's taking place at S1, S2, you might wait for R2 level. And in general, for midterm traders, you can wait even for piercing towards R2. But in general, if for those who play, let's say, daily traders for short profits, we always advise taking profit from 10 to 15% from overall of your money involved into the trade. And that's also how we do, and also how we analyze and assess if the videos and opinion videos were correct or not. Later, as promised, the assessment will come for previous year with all the videos analyzed and looking for success rates. The same we will do every year, actually, so stay tuned and wait for that analysis video as well. So with this being said, that's actually at the moment almost everything for CRVD. This is the numerical card. If you are more for graphical representation, you could look here. And speaking of how to average down, it's still classical. It's five portions, so it's 1-2-2 strategy. What does it mean? It means that the funds that you would like to play here, if you like this approach, you need to split in five portions. Then you can buy with one portion in the first circle. If price declines still on technical basis, you can average down with two portions in the second circle. And if negative catalyst kicks in, you can again average down and actually do a final support average down in the third circle. And speaking how to enter within the channel, it's still, because they are still broad, it doesn't mean that you need immediately buy in the top or wait till the bottom. You still want to enter slowly. It means, for example, if we speak about the second channel, if the price goes to 118 to 130, it means that these two portions, you still might split on two or three portions. And then if you look here, you can slowly enter. And by slowly entering, it would mean that Whenever the repulse takes place, because it might take place either on the top or the bottom, you will be still closer to the middle. So whenever the repulse is taking place and you are about to take your profits, you will take the maximum possible from there. So that's how to enter within the channel. It's also a very cautious play. Overall, the analysis and strategy discussed here is really about cautious, slow on daily basis entry without being too nervous. Just do it knowing what you do, what to expect, and actually when to take your profit. Again, taking profit at 10 to 15% is advised. So with this being said, that's now everything. That's all for CrowdStrike. Good luck with it. Also, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you're first time watching this video. Also, please press the bell button. This way, you will not miss our new videos and new interesting discussions for US-based stocks.